In today's video, I will explain myofascial connection around pelvis. You know, pelvis is very irregular shaped bone, right? It's not long bone. It's not just simple shaped bone. It's very irregular. That means there are many muscles attaching around pelvis. Then there are numerous myofascial connection around pelvis. Let me explain myofascial connection on back side. You are looking pelvis and hip joint from posterior view. I want to explain this muscle first. This is hamstrings. Hamstrings attach to here, this bony part. This is ischial tuberosity. Ischial tuberosity, this is also known as sit bone, okay? Hamstrings attach to ischial tuberosity. Then you see connective tissue attaching to ischial tuberosity. What is this one? This is sacrotuberous ligament. Sacrotuberous ligament. There is connection from hamstrings to ischial tuberosity. Ischial tuberosity to sacrotuberous ligament. Where is sacrotuberous ligament attaching to? It is sacrum, as the name of this ligament suggests. This is sacrotuberous ligament. Sacrum and ischial tuberosity. Again, from hamstrings. Hamstrings to ischial tuberosity to sacrotuberous ligament and sacrum. Then, what is above sacrum? There is back muscles. Let me pick two muscles. One is erector spinae. And next one, deeper one, is multifidus. These are back muscles, right? Again, hamstrings, sacrotuberous ligament, sacrum, erector spinae, multifidus. There is myofascial connection back side of body. Then, what is function of hamstrings? It is important for hip extension. Hip extension, right? Then, what is function of erector spinae and multifidus? That is trunk extension, right? So if these muscles get tight, it's hard to go to flexion position, right? What is flexion? It's basically bend forward stretching. You go down, you do a kind of a roll forward stretching. Does it make sense? If hamstrings and back muscles get tight, it's hard to go to a bending stretching. Does it make sense? So it's important to release this myofascial connection to accomplish to get flexibility. This is very important thing. Okay, this is the myofascial connection around ischium and sacrum. Let's go to a little bit lateral and a little bit superior. Now, you're looking pelvis from slightly superior view and lateral view. I want to focus on this bony ridge. This is part of ilium. This is iliac crest. This is very wide bony ridge on lateral part of pelvis. I want to focus on inferior part first. You see this muscle? This is gluteus medius. Gluteus medius attaches to inferior kind of part of iliac crest. Does it make sense? Plus, deep to gluteus medius, there's one more glute muscle. This is gluteus minimus. Actually, gluteus minimus is kind of far away from iliac crest. However, gluteus medius is kind of sitting on top of gluteus minimus. So they are like layer and layer. So gluteus minimus is indirectly affecting for iliac crest. Does it make sense? Again, gluteus medius is sitting on top of gluteus minimus. So it's like two layers. Then gluteus medius is close to iliac crest. Thus, you can say gluteus minimus is indirectly attaching to iliac crest. This is not logically correct, but this is how I see gluteus minimus and iliac crest relationships. This is just my way of visualization. Okay. Anyway, glutes muscles are close to iliac crest. This is below iliac crest. What is above iliac crest? they are basically core muscles. They are basically abdominal muscles. They are external oblique. External oblique. Internal oblique and transverse abdominis. These core muscles attach to superior part of iliac crest. That means if glutes muscles get tight, this tightness may affect for core muscles. Vice versa, if core muscles get tight, this tightness may affect for hip muscles, glutes muscles. Does it make sense? So, iliac crest is both important for hip muscles and core muscles. And let me explain one more thing regarding to hip and pelvis. When I do myofascial release around hip, pelvis, and lumbar area, I do movement to check where tightness is. That is hip flexion and hip extension. Why hip movement? Okay, basically, when your hip moves, your pelvis needs to move because they are connected. Again, when hip moves, pelvis needs to move together. What is in between pelvis? That's sacrum. And what is above sacrum? Lumbar spines. You can say hip, pelvis, sacrum, lumbar area is all one continuation. This is very important area. That is why I move my client's hip to evaluate where tightness is, where is aggravating this flow of movement. Hip flexion, hip extension is movement I use to evaluate where tightness is. Very important movement. Anyway, this is myofascial connection around ilium. Let's go to anterior part. Okay, this is anterior part. You are looking anterior part of hip and pelvis. I want to focus on this part. This is the most anterior part of ilium. This is ASIS. ASIS. And below ASIS, there is AIIS. It's basically this area. There are numerous muscles crossing this area. Basically, these muscles do hip flexion. Hip flexion, okay? Then, if these muscles get tight, it's hard to do extension. It's natural, right? So, when you want to do extension stretching, these muscles need to extend, of course. Plus, your abdominal area needs to lengthen as your hip goes to extension. Does it make sense? Again, if you want to go for hip extension, these muscles need to lengthen. Does it make sense? Then, simultaneously, your core muscles need good stretching. Because when your core muscle is very tight, it's hard to go to hip extension position. When your hip is in extension position, your core also needs to go to extension. So if your core muscles, such as rectus abdominis, is tight, if rectus abdominis is tight, it's hard to go to core extension. Even though if your hip is nice, but if your core is tight, it's hard to have a good length on anterior part of body. This relationship, anterior hip and core muscle relationship, is very important. Now, let me explain the last connection. The last part is about here. This is pubis. There are numerous adductor muscles attaching to pubis. Adductors. Yep, these guys attach to pubis. Then where can you go? You can go inside part of pelvis. Here. This kind of hammock kind of muscles on bottom of pelvis. This is pelvic floor. Pelvic floor. This muscle is very important for genital function, digestive system, urogenital function. Very important, right? So if your pelvic floor is tight or loosened up, this dysfunction may affect for adductor muscles. Or if your adductor is too tight, maybe your pelvic floor is too tight or may have disability for digestive system and urogenital function. Why adductor muscles and pelvic floor? because adductor muscles and pelvic floor are literally very, very close. So when you do kind of a Pilates exercise, yoga exercise, if you need to feel pelvic floor contraction, maybe you want to focus on adductor muscles because they are very close to each other. So one part may affect for another part. Oh my gosh, there are so many myofascial connections and muscle relationship around pelvic girdle. I hope this anatomy helps your career. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.